The first thing we're going to do is create a main screen. So I'll double click on Add New Screen. It'll create a screen. I'll right click and I'll just do Rename. We'll call it Main. So on the main screen, we're going to place some objects. And first I'm going to organize my work area to give me the most real estate here I can. And I'm going to drop the scale. Sometimes it's good to be able to see the entire screen at once. So the first object that we're going to place is going to be the screen window object. So I just left clicked it. I'm going to drop it on the screen and then I'm just going to kind of size it. So we're going to use this object to show other screen windows that we're going to be creating throughout this course. So I'll just kind of eyeball it here. And the idea is I'll put some navigation buttons down here to the left. We're going to put a text box at the top that's going to show us the name of the current picture. On the screen window, I'm going to open the properties dialog. And under fit to size, I'm going to choose fit screen and window. And then under miscellaneous, this is the object name here. They got screen window one. So I like to use Hungarian notation. And basically, when you name an object such as a tag or a visualization object or a variable in scripting, if you use Hungarian notation, you can look at it and you know exactly what data type it is and a good idea of what it's used for. So the way we do this is the first few characters are all lowercase and they indicate the type of the object or the data type. So this is a screen window. I'll just do SCRNW for screen window, and then we'll do a one uppercase character and I'll do main display window. So if we look at this name, the first part of it tells us it's a screen window. And then main display window kind of tells us what the function is. So a couple other options that we want to set on this is on Windows settings, I'm going to hit this drop down. I don't really want a heading or a border or minimize or maximize, so I'm just going to choose none. And that should just give us a border. And so the next thing we want to do is look at our height and width. If we're going to create screens that are going to fit inside of this, it's a good idea to note the height and width and then make those screens the same. That way they're going to fit in there nicely. I know that we have adapt picture and things like that, but it doesn't always work well. I'm going to use my arrow keys and just kind of nudge this object to the side so we've got plenty of space here and just kind of eyeball this a little bit more. So we've got a height of 1,000. That's a pretty round number. Let's make our width 1700. Okay, see how that looks. We may go back and adjust this once we start navigating screens and decide we want to make it a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller. But for now, that's going to work. Let's throw a button out there just to kind of get an idea of how big our buttons are going to be. So I'll just put a button and I'm going to go back to my 100% scale. And on this button, I'm going to do welcome, because when we press this button, ultimately it's going to show the welcome screen, which is going to be the next screen we create. And we'll go ahead and create the welcome screen. So just remembering the size of this, it is height of 1,000, width of 1700. So let's click Add New Screen. And then we'll right click and rename it. We'll call this welcome. And the first thing that we'll do is we will set the width and height. So the height is 1,000 and our width is 1700. In your class resources, there's an image and we will just set the background image of this screen object to be that image. If we scroll up here, you can see that we have some other properties. Under miscellaneous, we have background graphic. I'll just choose the drop-down icon. Notice we have a couple of buttons down here. Create graphic from file, create graphic from OLE object. So I'll just choose create graphic from file. And then I'll just use this welcome one JPEG. So you can use that. Or you can use one of your own if you wish. And then I'm going to add a text block on top of this. So in my basic objects, I'm just going to select text box. And I'm going to click there. I'm going to make this bigger. And for the text, I'm just going to add welcome to the Siemens WinCC Unified Integrators course! And then let's scroll up. set our font so that it's going to be nice and big. So we'll go with 32. And we'll just kind of size this. And then if we scroll down, our four color property is the font color. And let's try white. And then maybe making it bold might make it look a little better. So we'll go back into the font properties and choose bold. And because it's got the scroll bars, we will move it out. And then we'll hit save. Now let's go back to main. And what we want to do is we want this picture window object to show by default the welcome screen. So that is also a property. So if you go under general, we have screen. So we'll click on the browser button here and we'll choose the welcome screen and then the green checkbox. And then I'll hit save project. So before we go to runtime, there's one other setting that we need to look at, and that is the runtime settings. Notice how on screen one you see the green icon. That tells you that that is the start screen. So we want main to be our start screen. So we'll go to runtime settings. And then for our screen, I'll just hit the browser button. And we want main to be our start screen. And we'll choose the green checkbox. Save. And then let's go to runtime. I'll right click. Software only changes. And load. So I'll pull up a browser and refresh runtime. Log in. And here's our new main screen. So it looks like we've got plenty of room. We can probably make our picture window a little bit bigger, maybe give it a little bit more room. Now the button's not going to do anything. We haven't hooked that up yet. So I will go back to TIA portal. And if you haven't done this with me, go ahead and hit pause, create your main and welcome screen, and then we'll get started creating the other screens.